There's nothing sacred about the 6-foot rule. In some cases, it's inadequate, and in other cases, it's overly conservative. The problem with any measure, quantitative measure that limits one variable, is it's neglecting the interaction between these variables. If you have really high ventilation, maybe you can have more people. Staying at a certain distance or with a certain occupancy for a very short time is surely safe, but as time progresses, it always gets worse and worse and worse, and there's always a higher probability of infection. Hello, I'm Martin Bezant, professor of chemical engineering and mathematics at MIT. Welcome to this massive open online course, 10S95, Physics of COVID-19 Transmission. I have a paper on COVID-19 transmission, and I'm working on others, so I'm doing some scientific analysis in this area. By analyzing the available spreading data from super spreading incidents where the physical characteristics of the rooms are known, and to come up with quantitative guidelines to say, as a function of the various parameters in a certain space, the number of people, the ventilation, the size of the room, etc., what is the actual risk? How long can people spend in that room? How many people could be there? And really quantifying that risk in revised guidelines. So it's not enough just to qualitatively say, you should open the windows, or you should increase ventilation. Well, how much? What if we already have a lot of ventilation? Do we need more? And how many people can really be in that room safely, and for how long? Should we say that people can only go to work half of the time? Or should we reduce the occupancy? Or should we increase the testing frequency? So now we're testing every 3 days instead of every 9 days. These are all quantitative questions. The devil's in the details. If you can't put a number on these things, then nobody knows how to act. And so that has yet to be done by the official agencies. And it's my hope, actually, through this outreach and through this massive online course, that by teaching the physics of transmission and some of those scientific principles, quantitative guidelines to combat against it could be developed and advocated by public health agencies. So the aim of the course is to make the content understandable to as broad an audience as possible that has a certain baseline of technical competency. So you do need to have some understanding of undergraduate science and engineering, some familiarity with equations and formulas, also a little bit of familiarity with differential equations, but not much beyond that. On the other hand, for graduate students, we do have certain places in the course where I've recorded some boards which other students can just skip through. Which give a little more details in terms of the mathematical derivations behind the principles that we're teaching more towards the undergraduate level. I absolutely would like the general public to learn from this course. That can be accomplished partly by watching the interview videos and sort of scanning through some of the lightboard videos just to get the basic concepts, because many lightboard videos consist of myself drawing pictures on the board, doing simple scaling arguments, and talking about the principles, and then digressing to do some more mathematical, calculations, which may not be as quite broad interest. And it is my goal to reach public health officials, decision makers, business people, school teachers, anyone who is affected by the pandemic, but at least has that baseline of scientific understanding from, let's say, undergraduate level college, which may have been many years in the past, but I'm hoping still that with such a background, that a wide range of people could get something out of this course.